Honor, might I have a word?
What do you think of our little plot of land, Doctor?
It's quite beautiful. I'm grateful you found me. But to be truthful, people outside our community still avoid me like the bloody plague. It baffled me for a time, but then a courier delivered this to me. Before you found me, the British had demanded I not treat patriots nor their supporters. I refused, so they set about destroying my business. This tells me their smear campaign is still very much in effect. If things don't change, I may be forced to leave.
We need you here. I will do what I can to end this defamation.
You might start by finding the courier who brought this to me. He works out of Boston.
Connor!
What is happening?
Found this guy skulking around the inn. I pressed him, and it turns out he's looking for a deserter. Goes by the name of Big Dave. Says he's alone. Isn't that right?
I am! I'm alone! I swear it!
Bloody hell. Another one, Connor. If he gets back to his officers, I'm done for.
Where is he?
Coward kicked me in the gingham of Bob's, then threw sand in Dave's eyes. But he's long gone now.
Not good, Connor.
No. We can expect visitors soon.
They'll have to get through us first.
Connor! Connor!
Coming, David. We need to be ready.
Who is coming?
Redcoats. David's to be tried for treason. Executed, more than likely.
Connor, glad you're here. I want to show you something. I've collected these kegs. I might suggest building an ambush in the event we need it. They'll likely have numbers at least 2-1.
For you bastard! Quick! He's right there!
Connor, I'm sorry for bringing this violence on the village.
We protect our own. The British will not risk losing more soldiers for one deserter. You are free of it now.
You have business in New York on occasion? I only ask because I ordered a package from France and it's long overdue. I've written a postmaster and he's yet to respond. I thought you could inquire in person if you had the chance.
I will pass by the next time I am there.
Day goes by that one of the boys doesn't hurt himself. I'll get some rest with the doctor around, sending the boys his way.
I know what you mean. Maria is all over the property like a mad girl. Nora's found her in his mine yesterday with a great big gash in her knee. That girl, I tell you.
It sounds like you all have your hands full.
Well, you could say that.
Having the doctor here is great for all of us, Connor. Thank you for finding him and bringing him here.
He came here because of you. I only brought him the offer. It is beautiful, old man.
It is. I've found a painting for the space above the mantle. It's being held in New York. If you get a moment, I'd like you to pick it up for me.
Certainly.
Good. It may not be there, as the house where it was stored lay in the path of the Great Fire. If so, worry not.
I have come to inquire on a package arriving from France on behalf of Lance O'Donnell.
Was picked up and signed for by his apprentice a couple of days back, Patrick O'Hara.
Patrick O'Hara is Mr. O'Donnell's former apprentice. Would you happen to know where he is?
Sure. He's been hanging around the docks the last few days. Should be round the way. Here, take these pages and hide them. Don't let that guy get his hands on you.
This way, old boy.
Watch out, you pillar!
Hand them to Meal!
In my sight, clear as day.
I think I can hit him!
So slow!
It would have burned had it not been here. Achilles will be pleased.
I have the painting you sent me for. Would you like some help hanging it?
Maybe not just yet.
Thank you.
What is it, old man?
Just an old painting.
I have gathered that much. Why will you not open it?
It is something close to me. Something that I can't bear to look at just yet. Perhaps someday I will muster up the courage to gaze upon it again. But not yet.
I have your plans. What are they for?
You got them! This, Connor, is the design for a chair that folds. Genius! You won't regret this.
Great timing. I was just getting underway on something that might be of interest to you.
What is that?
Those plans you retrieved for me. And believe you me, they were worth all the fuss. A folding chair.
I do not follow you.
It's a chair that folds, Connor. You can fold it right up and stack them. Store them, transport them. I could have 1,000 chairs in my back room. It's simple brilliance, and I am going to make a fortune.
A folding chair. Hmm. Well, I wish you the best with it.
You'll see, Connor. You'll see!
Connor, I'm so glad you're here. The plans I bought, they weren't just a folding chair. Oh, no, they had something else with them. Something quite astonishing. A flying machine designed by Leonardo da Vinci himself. And I've built it. You can be the first to try it if you like. You'll be able to fly, soar like an eagle.
And it works?
Da Vinci was one of the greatest minds in human history. As brilliant a man as there has ever been. You can be certain it works. Would you like to try?
Yes. Such a device would certainly prove useful.